Hello, my name is Miles Nerma. I'm the Director of Design for Aston Martin. I'd like to walk you around our latest special project, the V12 Speedster. As is the case with most of our cars, it's always best to start at the front. And I'd like to talk to you about some of the inspiration behind the car and also some of the features within it. And obviously every Aston Martin starts with its grille. This grille, very much inspired by the probably greatest Aston Martin grille there's ever been, which is the DB5. But intertwined, we have lots of other little bits and feelings from other cars. And in fact, the car is peppered with sort of quite iconic parts and feelings from maybe what I'd call our greatest hits. So above the grille, we have an extra air vent. Now, this car has a unique platform, and we're very lucky with the way we build our cars in the fact that we have almost a modular system that allows us to take parts from other cars within the range to make something very special and very unique. V12 Speedster uses parts from the DBS, parts from Vantage, parts from DB11 Volante to make the car that you're seeing in front of you. Now, part of that is squeezing a V12 under what is quite a low bonnet for an Aston Martin. So we have this huge C-shaped clamshell at the front. We delete all the split lines wherever we can. And in fact, we use the split line to create an air vent to feed that V12 right at the front. In some ways, it's inspired by DB5, but in other ways, it's a very, very modern interpretation. But that low nose with that air scoop at the front gives the car immediately quite an attitude. Now, as well as that, we have these outboard air vents. This car needs a lot of cooling, basically, for the power that we're delivering to it. At the side of the car, we have a graphic somewhat inspired by 177. And actually, you see here that the side strake feature is actually molded into the car. We took off some of the, in this instance, some of the jewelry, but we put in some very deep sculpture onto the side of the car. Just behind that, we have really these twin cockpits. And the car, obviously a major inspiration for this car was CC100, a show car that we did back in 2013. That had these twin cockpits and they're separated out with a bar running down the middle, which gives a very, very unique feeling. When you traveled in CC100, you had this incredible feeling inside of it with this bar quite high up in your vision that separated the cockpit between you and your passenger. So inside you will see our new lightweight carbon fiber seat with the padding and pretty well a unique interior for this car. We've had to move many of the elements because of the setup, no windscreen, this bar down the center, no side glass. A lot of the components are moved around inside the car. Along with the air vents, everything's supposed to give this sort of slightly jet fighter feel. And in the early prototypes, we've even used a sort of red tags, a sort of pull before flight feeling within that area. We've got these twin humps on the rear deck. Now, in this version, they actually have two clear windows on either side. Again, to give that jet fighter cockpit type feeling, we've done this. And in fact, if you below it is an area where you can keep your crash helmet. So when you've parked up, you can actually pop them in the back. The boot is the shut line for the boot for the trunk is a very, very different to any of our cars. So very unique feature. Something really you'd see normally on a show car, not something that reaches production. But with these special projects, that is just always what we're striving to achieve. We've gone for twin exhaust, but central and either side, giving this like catamaran feeling are these diffusers. Above the exhaust, you have a beam rear wing. So you'll recognize the graphic, the Aston Martin moustache line that you'll see on the grille that's also echoed here in the rear lamp graphic. This time, underneath it, you've actually got an aero duct to actually help the airflow round the back of the car and give the car stability and downforce at speed.